Okay. Actually, right. The first name is. Hello. Actually, the first name is Parveen Singh. Parveen Singh. Oh. And last name is.
I'm just getting so confused now. Are you Praveen Rahal?
No, my first name is Parveen Singh. Last name is Rahal. Okay. The first name.
Parveen Singh.
So, hello guys. So, here we are. Praveen wants to go for an eye checkup because he thinks his number has some fluctuation. So, we are called the eye specialist, but they said that they want a referral from the general practitioner. So, we called the general practitioner, booked an appointment, which is in like 10 minutes. Right now, it's 7 p.m. and our appointment is 7:10. So we'll go there, and in the morning we call the NIB insurance and ask them about our cover. So general practitioner is 100% covered, and specialist will be 85% covered. So let's see how it goes. We'll go there, and
where is the card? You have to.
Yeah. So he'll get his card, and we'll go there, and let's see how it goes.
So. Here he is, and yeah, that's the card. So yeah, we'll go and use this card, and let's see how it goes. Let's go, bro.
Yeah, make it fast.
We will reach there by time. So it's 7 p.m. in the evening, and everything is quiet.
A few moments later.
So guys, here we are, Para Hills 365 Days Medical Center, and we have appointment at 7:10. It is like only 1 kilometer from our house. It's a general practitioner. So let's get inside and see how it goes. So guys, here we are, and we got the reference letter from the doctor. So I'll tell you what happened at the clinic. So we went there, we filled up a form, and then after like half an hour, the doctor called our name. We went inside. He talked with him about his medical condition. So he had a headache and stuff like that. He checked his pressure, and pressure was a bit high. So he told him to rest for like 10 minutes, and then he checked the pressure again. And after all of that, he gave us this reference, which is not an eye specialist, but it is an optical superstore. So basically he wants us to go to a optical shop to buy new specs. That's it. So yeah, but the process is like that. You have to fill up a form. After that, they will ask you for the card we showed. Where is the card?
Not here.
Okay. Then they told us to show the card, the NIB card. We gave him, and also we gave him the. Also, they asked about the photo ID. So we gave the photo ID, and we didn't have to pay anything upfront over there. They will collect it from the insurance company. So they'll fax them, and they will do the payment. So we didn't have to do anything about the payment stuff because it was a general practitioner. So, and it was only the consultation charge. It was covered by NIB. So yeah, that's it. And overall, I think actually both of us think that the medical process, it is a bit lengthier than in India or Pakistan or like the Asian countries. For a small thing like eye checkup, there is a big procedure. So I think I heard it before, but I realized it today that the medical and healthcare in countries like Australia, USA is very complex. It's very complicated and it's very lengthy. So yeah, that was our experience. So I hope you like this video. So guys, now I'll tell you all about OSHC. Let's go.
The next day.
OSHC is the visa requirement if you want to come to Australia. So if you are applying a student visa, you have to have an OSHC because it's a visa requirement. You can't enter in Australia without that. You cannot even file your visa without an OSHC. So there are many companies that provide this OSHC. So I'll show you the screen and I will compare various OSHC provider. So it is very important that before buying an OSHC, you should do your own research and check that which companies cover the most and which company gives you the most benefit. So every company has different type of covers. So you should compare them and check it out before buying any of the OSHC. And one more thing, when you arrive to Australia, you just need to let them know. Either you call them, you email them, or go on their website and let them know that you have arrived in Australia and give them your address so that they can provide you something like this. So this is an NIB OSHC card which you can use while going to a medical practitioner or any kind of medical emergency. So now let's go to the screen and compare the providers.
So here we are. Before buying any OSHC cover, you should compare the companies which are providing this cover so that you can know how much it can cover. So let's go for it. So I will type in OSHC Australia, and this is the website, Compare Overseas Students. So oshcaustralia.com. You just need to give a policy date. For example, we are going for 1st of May 2020, 31st of May 2022 for 2 years. So if you are going for a master's, just get the quote for 2 years. So these are the company, as you can see. So I have Bupa and my friend Praveen has NIB. There is a reason why we have these two and not the other ones. So here you can see the prices. Also you can see many parameters like visa compliance, in hospital and out hospital treatment, other waiting periods, extra features and stuff like that. So this all complies the visa, so it's all right. What we have to see is in hospital and out hospital treatment. So in hospitals, some of them have collaboration with all hospitals, and some of them has only public and limited agreements only. So this way you can check them. And in our case today, we are going for a specialist. So as Praveen has the NIB, so it will give him 85% of the cover, and I have Bupa, so I will get 100% of the cover. So for me it would be free of charge, and for him it would be 85% covered. So this is how you can compare and buy the best option possible for yourself. One of the other thing I want to tell is the refund policy. NIB and Bupa has no fees for the refund. So if your visa get cancelled, you will get all of your money returned for the OHSC, while others has limited fees may apply. So there might be some fees you have to pay to get the refund. So this is the scenario. So this is how you can check it.
So guys, now I will tell you how to find a nearby provider as per your need. So I will go to the screen again and I will show you how to find a nearby healthcare provider or doctor. So let's go.
So guys, here we go. So I'll just simply type need, and we'll go to the website. We'll go to the health or health insurance, international students, and here find a general practitioner. Here we can search like today we have to go to eye specialist for eye checkup. Let's suppose we have to go to the eye specialist for eye checkup. So I'll get the eye, and I think eye specialist, and our location, Para Hills, South Australia. So it will show you the doctors nearby.
So these are the doctors, and there are some information as well, like 29 NIB members seen over last 12 months. 100% of the NIB members had no out-of-pocket cost. $0 was charged. So like this, this is the whole list of the doctors nearby, which are the eye specialist with NIB. So we have to book an appointment. But as we got to know today, if you want to go to the specialist, you have to have a referral. So before going to the specialist, we have to go to a general practitioner, GP, around us. So this is a list of all providers. So you have to call them, contact them and make an appointment, and they will do your basic checkup, and if there is any need, they will give a reference to the specialist, and then we can go to the specialist. So this is how it works. Similarly, for MUPA, it's the same case. You can just type your area and whatever need, whatever requirement you have, and you will get the list of the doctors nearby you. So you can go and do the checkup.
So now I will show you.
So guys,